So we have already learned about nested if statement. So we will use that in the program. So one example program is here. This is to check the nature of roots of quadratic equation. First, I'll explain what does it mean. Then I'll show you a program using nested if. See, here I have a quadratic equation. A equation whose degree is 2 is called as quadratic. X square plus x plus nothing, that is 1. So ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. If it is 0 equal to 0, then you can find the roots. So then only it is called as equation. That is quadratic equation. We already learned it in the previous videos, but again I am repeating it. Then roots, what is the formula? Right, every student knows this one. The formula is minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. This is the formula. Now, if you know the values of a, b, c, you can substitute them here and you can get the root. And for getting the root, another time we take minus, we get another root. So actually we get two roots, right? Because this is quadratic, so two values of x are possible. Now let us come to the point. See, inside this root, if b square minus 4ac is becoming 0, if this whole thing is 0, then what happens? Minus b plus 0 or minus b minus 0. It's the same thing only. So 0 has no value if b square minus 4ac has become 0. 0 has no value. Whether you take plus or minus, you get the same answer. What is that? Minus b by 2a. You get the same answer. Minus b by 2a. So that value is 0. So this means if you take both the roots are same only. Because if you take plus 0 also, you get same answer, minus 0 also same answer. So it looks like this, minus b plus 0 by 2a or minus b minus 0 by 2a. See, 0 has no value. So both the roots are same only. So both the roots will be equal. Means this b square minus 4ac, if it is 0, then both the roots will be equal. That's it. Then one more thing. If that b square minus 4ac is less than 0, let us say, example, let us say we got minus 5. Do you know the root of minus 5? No, we cannot find the root of minus 5. So it means we cannot know the roots. Then what do you call if you have a root under root minus 1? We say number is imaginary. We don't know the answer. We cannot find the roots. So we learn two things. If that portion is 0, roots are same only. If that portion is negative, we cannot find roots. If it is positive, then we have two roots and they are not same. They are different. So that's what, look at this now. Discriminant. So this b square minus 4ac is called as discriminant. Let us say d, call it as d. Now if that d is 0, means roots are real and also equal. That's what I said, they are equal. And if d is greater than 0, means they are real, but they are not equal, they will be different. Third one, if d is less than 0, means they are not real, they are imaginary. So if you have any quadratic equation, there are three different natures of a quadratic equation, roots of quadratic equation. They may be real and equal, they may be real and unequal, or they may be imaginary. So if else, then if else, like this, we have cases here. So we have to do nested if. So let us write on the program directly. So here inside the program, I have variables for a, b, c, d and roots also. A, b, c for the coefficients of this quadratic equation a, b, c, and d is for discriminant, and root 1 and root 2 for finding two roots. Now already I have taken a, b, c three values. Then here, first of all, I should find out the discriminant. So let us find out discriminant. D is assigned with b square, that is b into b, minus 4ac, that is 4 into a into c. We got the discriminant. Next, now I have to write if and else. First one, if this d is equal to 0, this d is equal to 0, mean roots are equal and real. So I will give a message. See out, roots are real and equal. Roots are real and equal. I will finish writing this. Then after this, I want to display roots also. That is minus b by 2a. So here, next line, see, here after this, I should write nl. but there is no space, so I will write here. You can even write NDEL in the beginning of the display part also. So NDEL, what I should display when the roots are equal? Minus b by 2a. So directly I will write down here, minus b divided by 2 into a, and this should be in the bracket, and this entire thing also, if it is in bracket, that's better. So this entire result you get, right? Roots are equal, real and equal, then you get the result. There is single value, they are equal, no? So it's a single value. This is inside if d is equals to 0. If d is not 0, then what it could be? Greater than 0, less than 0. So let us write for greater than 0, else, right? So here itself I can write on if d is greater than 0. So actually I can write flower bracket, inside the bracket also I can write, because just after else I have if, so I can write it here itself. Then if d is greater than 0, then I will see out roots are real and unequal. So I will write down this whole thing. Roots are real and unequal, then I will display both the roots. So first is NDEL, I will display it in a new line. Then first root is what? Minus b plus sqrt of d, then this whole thing divided by 2 into a. This is one result. Then again c out and l, this whole thing as it is, just write minus here, right? So this is for positive and this for negative. I don't have to write on this completely, already we have done it in the previous video, in the beginning videos. So that same formula you can write on here, right? Then at last else, just else means if this is not equal, this is not greater than else. So here else I have only single statement, so say c out imaginary, right? Imaginary, just I am scribbling here because there is no space, so you can understand this, just say imaginary. So I guess you have understood how to write on this one. So write a program by yourself, and also there is a demo available. This is for displaying the nature of the roots as well as we are displaying the roots, all right? So that's all in this video.